again.
Very cool. Next up is Montos. Montos.
So I'm challenging you to pronounce my last name right.
Yeah, I know Papa.
Okay. Okay, okay.
You have 4 minutes. I put your presenter so you can choose your presentation. Wait, lighting 1, 0, 3.
Well, where's my presentation? I found it. Okay, so I'm starting my clock. So I'm starting like August 2019, we contacted from FOSSA Systems, and they said that they had secured a position flying on the first flight of the Firefly, a new company launching a rocket in space, and they had secured a position for a flight that was meant to be March 2020. So they said us that they want us to build, to put two Pico satellites inside and build also the deployer. We said that we are okay, we know how to build a deployer. We had no idea how to do it. So we took the opportunity to fly our first deployer and first open source Pico satellite deployer in space. We went through the ICD and we hit our first milestone, which was to send to Firefly a mass dummy. So this was September 2019, less than a month to build a mass dummy, which meant to have the mass of the final deployer and also the center of mass accurately by 1%, and also the moment of inertia with the same deployer. So we did some decisions on the first month. We had to follow through the rest of the project, and then we started testing and doing. This was supposed to be a video, but it's not. Okay, testing the rails, testing the release mechanism. This is October 2019 through the last in-person open source CubeSat workshop. And this is again testing, and this was the final design, and it was ready November 2019, and the first parts started to come in the shop, and this was a mixed of the qualification parts plus plastic and 3D printed door made for testing again. And this was in my birthday, actually, 3 of December of 2019, so less than 3 months. This is the qualification model. We got qualified, and then we ordered the flight model parts. This is February 2020, and we built the deployer, went for qualification, again for testing, and we did the by February 2020 we have complete everything. The deployer was ready to fly, and then we were waiting because the flight had some then COVID came in, and there were some delays, and then delays and more delays and more delays. And we finally shipped the deployer with the satellites at October 2020, almost a year after the project started, and like 6 months after supposed to be the flight. And then we waited again, and at September 2 of 2021, now a year after, it was the time for the rocket to fly. And then this is the deployer inside the fairing, and 5 minutes after, at 15 kilometers altitude, this happened. So they said that we have another position, and we need to start this again from start. So this was the story about the first open source pocket satellite deployer, and we also make the second like the same one to fly to the second flight, and also we build a new one, more lighter and more efficient. And yeah, if you want to follow us, you know where to find us. I'm Mantos from Libraspace Foundation. Yeah.
Thank you, Mantos. Yeah, amazing. So yeah, it crashes that life, you know, c'est la vie. And you repeat again and do better. That's cool. Good philosophy. So for Mantos, everybody, please turn on your microphone. 3, 2, 1.
Yeah!
Yeah!
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, an open source deployer. All right, we need that. Thank you, Mantos.
Bye.
Is Manolis Souligas? I hope you're here. Yeah, you are. So.